Bad news. Felix Bautista, their great closer, elbow damage, came out of the game last night in that ninth inning. Extended it, not yet known. How long he'll be out, not yet known, but maybe their toughest loss could be this guy, and looks like he's going to be out. Felix Bautista, their closer. Kyle Bradish comes in at 8-6, 3.03 earned run average. His last start, very good one at Oakland. Six scoreless innings, eight strikeouts, just one walk. Against the Rockies, first career start. Very good slider, got a power curveball, mixes in a changeup as well, and really tough on right-handed hitters.
Two strikes on McMahon, two outs here in the top of the first.
Pitch to McMahon, swing and a miss, he got him. And a nice, smooth 1-2-3 inning. Rockies go 1-2-3, Orioles coming to bat, no score.
The Rockies will start Chris Flexen. He's 1-5, 7.18 earned run average. His last start was a game against the White Sox, might have been his best start of the season. Allowed two runs in six innings, no decision for him. That's when the White Sox came back late in the ballgame. Against Baltimore, as a member of the Mariners, two starts. He's gone 1-0 against the Orioles, 4.91 earned run average.
Chris Flexen trying to make it a 1-2-3 bottom of the first. 3-2 here to Santander. Swing and a miss. Got him with a changeup. Beautiful pitch for Chris Flexen. No score after one.
He is MVP of this year's All-Star game, having a nice season. 272 batting average, 13 homers, and 60 driven in.
Right-handers 2-0. And that's hit into right field. That's going to be a base hit. Another hit for Elias Diaz, going the other way with that pitch. And a leadoff single for the Rockies, their first hit tonight. Harold Castro, the DH tonight, is next. Left-handed hitter. Two outs, a runner at second base. One ball, one strike on Castro. No score, top of the second here in Baltimore.
1-1 to Castro. Bounce to the right side. Frazier's there. Has it. Throws to Mountcastle. And that's the third out. So a leadoff single from Diaz, but no damage from the Rockies. No score.
We go to the top of the third inning here in Baltimore. No score. Michael Tolia leads off of the Rockies. Tolia on this road trip, 1-for-5. The one hit was a home run. And it's hit down that left field line, slicing away from Hayes into the corner. It'll be extra bases for Michael Tolia. He will stop at second base with a stand-up double. Excellent piece of hitting. Going the other way on the pitch on the outside for Tolia. And there's the first extra base hit for the Rockies tonight. Ground ball, base hit in the left field. Off the glove of the third baseman Urias. Holding at third base will be Michael Tolia. Tolia safe at third. At first base is Doyle with a single. First and third, nobody out. Great opportunity now for the Rockies to get on the board first tonight. Charlie Blackman, the hitter, popped out to the third baseman his first time up.
Charlie drives it to right. This will get a run home. Doyle galloping towards third. 1-0 Colorado. Three consecutive hits. And the Rockies have the third inning lead.
Charlie coming through with his 32nd RBI of the year.
So he's at first, Blackman is, Doyle's at third, a run in, nobody out, Ezekiel Tovar the hitter, flied out to right the first time up. And the next 1-2 pitch, and a broken bat, grounder towards second. Charlie Blackman in a rundown, they throw to first to get the out. Blackman's in between, gets hit in the back by a throw and is safe at first base. Doyle has scored in the play. That happened before that play, so there's an out at first base. Let the Rockies score again, 2-0 Colorado.
The Rockies, two runs, four hits, no errors. The Orioles, no runs and a hit. Rockies got their two runs last inning. Nolan grounded to the second baseman Frazier his first time up.
Swing and a miss. Jones down on strikes.
And all of a sudden, the breaking balls are beginning to come for Kyle Bradish.
Two to Rogers. Called strike three. A curveball that dotted the outside corner at the knees. A thing of beauty from Kyle Bradish. He strikes out the side in the fourth.
Good fourth inning for Kyle Bradish. But it's still 2-0 Rockies. Bottom of the fourth inning. Rockies have a 2-0 lead here in Baltimore. More. Chris Flexen has hit a man and allowed a single. Anthony Santander struck out on a changeup his first time up. Pitch is strike three called. This time a fastball that he painted the outside corner at the knees with. Second hit by the Orioles to keep the inning alive. The guy who had the first hit, Ryan O'Hearn. The 3-2 to O'Hearn swing and a miss. Got him with the changeup. Chris Flexen looking solid again tonight. 2-0 Rockies after four. There's the first walk of the night for either side. The Orioles with some options. The speedy Mullins, who hit into a double play to end their scoring threat. The only one they've had previously off Flexen.
Swing and a miss. Throw to second base is wide and into center field. Hayes will motor on to third, and he'll make it there with just one out. Mullins is down on strikes, but give Hayes a stolen base and then an error by the catcher Diaz.
And the Orioles with another opportunity with a runner at third base and less than two out.
And that is to shortstop. Tovar's coming home. Play at the plate. Hayes is out at the plate. With the infield playing back, Tovar threw home. You never see that. Now, Baltimore's challenging the play.
Boy, that is close. That is close. Because you can see the catcher, Diaz. He was not totally blocking the plate at first, but then he went in the path of the ball. And when the path of the ball took him more to the plate, and they are allowed to do that. You can go as a catcher to receive the ball in the path. Question is, was he blocking too much of the plate to begin with?
After review, there is a blocking violation at the plate.
Well, Bud Black has to come out and argue this for the Rockies. You know he has to. It's a hard rule to interpret. The run will score. It's now a 2-1 game.
First and second for Baltimore in the bottom of the sixth inning. Nobody out. Rockies holding a 2-1 lead. Right on right, he's got Ryan Mountcastle.
Mountcastle to left field. That is dropping, and it's a fair ball. Fair ball, they'll go into the corner. Henderson ties it. Santander being sent home, and he will score. And the Orioles take the lead. A two-run double for Ryan Mountcastle, and it's 3-2 Baltimore.
This team just continues to amaze me with the big hits. Runners in scoring position, fifth best in baseball, and Mountcastle comes through yet again, his 20th double of the year.
Runner advances Mountcastle to third. Productive out for Ryan O'Hearn. One out with a man at third base, and the Rockies will bring the infield in.
Infield in, it's right to the shortstop. Play home, but it's bobbled by the shortstop. And outers are cornered, but Mountcastle scores. Tovar couldn't handle it. He was trying to throw before he had the baseball on that slow roller by Austin Hayes. It was hit right to the shortstop. Tovar with the infield in. The Orioles have scored three times, and they now have a 4-2 lead.
Kyle Bradish is done for the evening. Six hits through six plus innings of work, eight strikeouts.
Bradish, his 15th outing, going at least six for the second-year right-hander. If the Orioles bullpen can get nine outs, he'll become a nine-game winner. But this is, at least for 15 days, life without the big guy.
It is 4-2 Orioles. Anthony Santander is the hitter.
And it's ripped fair down the left field line. Westberg to third base. Westberg around third. The throw from left field. Play at the plate. Too late. Westbrook scores from first, and it's 5-2 Baltimore.
Rockies are down 5-2. Elias Diaz, a single and three tries tonight. Drive to left by Diaz. They're going to send Ryan McMahon. He is going to score without a throw. Rockies get one back. 5-3 Baltimore. The Rockies have the tying runs aboard with nobody out after a run home and a bouncing ball, Brendan Rodgers to short. They go to second for one, on to first for a double play. Scoring is Elias Diaz, but that's a big pitch for D.L. Hall. It's been a tough swing on the road for Brendan with the bat.
That's exactly what the Orioles are looking for, that ground ball double play. The run scores, but
5-4 game.
We are headed to the ninth. It's not mountain time this time. It's Yennier Cano time as he'll try to close this one out.
It's been a tough go in the last day, but the Orioles in out away from winning their 81st game. Gunner! Makes the catch, and Yennier Cano gets it done. A 5-4 Baltimore win.